My name is Rick Smith. I'm the product manager for Microfocus Fortify WebInspect and WebInspect Enterprise. Today, I'll walk you through scanning with our containerized version of WebInspect. A few notes. There are two supported modes of scanning that I'll cover. First, we'll cover the command line mode. Next, we'll cover API mode. In this video, we'll primarily cover the Docker-specific nuances to using command line and API scanning modes in our containerized WebInspect. Keep in mind that our APIs are fully documented via Swagger and the command line capabilities of WebInspect are covered in the help. Finally, for more detail about anything I cover in this video, check out the Fortify WebInspect on Docker guide. Now let's get started. With the container pulled, we're ready to start scanning. The WebInspect container supports two modes of scanning, command line mode and API mode. Both modes require an environment file which specifies different details about the scan mode. This file is then referenced via the Docker run command. Here's my environment file for an example command line scan. Here you can see I'm specifying the mode. Mode 1 maps back to the command line scan mode. Both modes will require licensing information. So here I'm specifying my local infrastructure manager server. This is a server that's on my network. This is the pool and the password information to pull a license from that server. And then I'm specifying different scan arguments that map back to the standard WebInspect command line scan arguments. So dash U would specify the URL, dash S would specify a settings file. This is a settings file that I've saved to this host directory. I'll mention that in a moment. This is a very targeted settings file that will return very fast results. I'm then specifying the vulnerability report or the standard vulnerability report that I want to export out to PDF. And then finally, I'm exporting the full scan file as well out to the host operating system. This scan zero references the environment file that I will reference from my Docker run command. The Docker run command that I'll use looks like this. In this example, I'm using the dash IT parameter. This will put put Docker in an interactive mode. For most scanning purposes, you would probably want to use dash D. This will be detached mode. But again, IT in dash IT mode, you'll be able to see the results of the scan right there from the Windows PowerShell prompt. Dash RM will remove any remnant files after the container has finished running. And then I'm specifying my environment file. I've saved that environment file that I mentioned just a moment ago, where I mapped back to my license server and I specified the command mode and the arguments. I've saved that to my C drive. This could be stored anywhere on the host OS, but this is the file that I'll reference via this my Docker command. The key to this is that I'm doing a mapping between a folder on this host OS and the host folder on the container. So this C:// Docker folder exists on my host OS. If I go here, you can see the XML file that I referenced in the previous file that I showed. So with that, I will copy this command and I'll execute this. And momentarily you'll see a container has been spun up and then you'll start getting feedback from the WebInspect container. Again, if you ran this with Docker run dash D, it would be in detached mode. So you wouldn't see the feedback, but for the purpose of this demonstration, it makes more sense to kind of show you what's going on. As I mentioned in the environment file, we specified a lim URL. You can see that being used here to pull a license. These are the command line arguments that are being passed to my scan within the container. So here in a moment, you'll see the scan starts and starts returning feedback to the PowerShell prompt. Here you can see the feedback from the WebInspect command line being obviously piped back through the Windows PowerShell prompt using interactive mode. This is giving us detail about the scan. So the scan ID within the container, information about the allowed host, different restrictions, so on and so forth. This scan will then run for a few moments. When the scan finishes, it will export the report as well as the scan to my host OS via the mapping that I created earlier right here. As the scan runs and complete, you'll get the standard feedback that you would via the command line in any normal WebInspect install. Here you can see vulnerability information that's fed back. You can see the scan time, then the export of the scan as well as the report. If we get to the bottom here, you can see that the scan is now successfully finished and this container has finished running. If I go back to my Docker folder that I mapped earlier, you'll see that I have the scan that has exported. I also have a report. This report will be a PDF report that WebInspect generated as at the close of that scan. So again, using the Docker container, we were able to run a command line scan. As I mentioned, any of the command line options that exist in WebInspect could be used via that container. We also have an API mode. So let's switch over to that API mode and do a quick demo of how to use that. To leverage the WebInspect API via the container, you'll need an environment file and a Docker run command similar to the command line option. The environment file is a little different. As we display the environment file here, we'll specify the mode as to that turns on the WebInspect API within the container. We'll still need the same licensing information that we needed previously. The main difference here is that we'll specify the host that the API should listen on. This would be the container host. We'll also specify the port that it'll listen on and the authentication type. From there, we'll use a Docker run command that references this environment file. This is the run command that we will use. Here you can see I'm still using interactive mode. That's for the purpose of this demo. In a normal environment, you would probably want to run in detached mode. Again, I'll use interactive mode. We'll remove the container when we're complete. This is required. Here we're doing a mapping between port 8083 in the container and port 8083 on the host OS. This gives us the ability to access that port. As I mentioned, we'll specify the environment file. That's the environment file that I just mentioned. Memory, CPU, and then the rest of this is you know, very similar to the command line mode. So if I copy this, paste it here and run. Again, in interactive mode, we should get feedback indicating that the API has started, a license has been obtained, so on and so forth. Here you can see attaching to the SQL server, starting the API using the arguments that we passed. At this point, the API is up and listening. So let's verify that we can access the Swagger API docs on this container. There's some limitations to accessing the container from the host, so we'll use a remote browser for accessing the API docs. As I pull up my browser, I'll target the API docs via the IP address of the host machine. Remember, we mapped port 8083, then I'll hit the WebInspect API. Here you can see I have access to the full WebInspect REST API. This is on the host IP address mapped into that Docker container via port 8083. So we can see we have the full access to the Swagger docs. Let's just run a quick scan using Postman to validate full operation of the WebInspect API. Here I'm referencing the WebInspect API within my Docker container. I'm leveraging the scan's endpoint and a post. This will create a new scan. In the JSON payload, you can see I'm referencing my default settings file that comes with the WebInspect, with any WebInspect as well as inside the container. And then I'm applying some overrides. One is a scan name override. I'm applying an override for the start URL, and then I'm telling it to scan and crawl in audit mode. So it'll spider the app and then audit the app. I'll go ahead and send this. In a moment, the API will return with an scan ID GUID. We'll be able to use that GUID to query the status of the scan, to pull results from the scan, so on and so forth. Here you can see I've got the GUID returned. So now at this point, my scan is running. To get the status of the scan, I'll copy that scan GUID. I'll then do a GET on the scan's endpoint with that scan ID and the action URL parameter set to get current status. I'll then send this request. And in a moment, you'll see the status returned as running. Once the scan has gone to the completed phase, you're ready to start working with the data from the scan. So exporting PDFs, exporting scans, so on and so forth. Thank you for watching. Keep an eye on the Fortify Unplugged YouTube channel for more content.